In recent years, you've seen the Traxxas name show up in a number of full-size motorsports events, from their full-size short course trucks, the AMA motocross, monster trucks, and now you even have them coming to the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series with none other than Rowdy. Oh yeah, Kyle Busch. And they have a 1/16 scale replica of his Camping World Truck Series Kyle Busch Racing truck, and we are here today to put it through its paces. Now, there are two different versions of this truck, and the one that we are testing here today is the one that comes with the brushed motor. There is a version that comes with a brushless motor as well, gets a little bit more speed and a little bit more performance. Out of the box, the truck comes out of the box completely ready to run. The only thing you'll need to pick up for it is a set of AA batteries for the transmitter. I was actually a bit surprised that those weren't included, but everything else is in there for you to get this truck up and running. The body comes out of the box as you see it here, fully detailed. All the decals are pre-applied for you. You've got these gorgeous looking Goodyear replica tires on the side. You also have your main battery pack and main battery charger. Now, out of the box, like I mentioned too, it is a fully assembled chassis for you, and it's the same basic chassis, or very similar to what you'll find on the drift car, like the Boss Mustang that they have out there, the Kent Block Gymkhana car, and they've taken that platform and really brought it to the truck series vehicles, and it does a great job. If you look at it, it looks great. We're here in our local parking lot here, and we're just gonna do some laps with it and see exactly how it performs. Let's run some batteries through this bad boy. The four-wheel drive definitely provides plenty of bite when you get on the power. Good pep and speed. I'd say top speed is about 20, 25 miles an hour. Out of the box, they recommend that you put the battery pack in the left-hand side of the chassis. There's actually two battery pockets, we'll call them, where you can put the battery pack. You can actually get a Y harness so that you can run dual 6-cell packs. You can also run LiPo batteries with this, which will increase your top speed even more. It's kind of neat too with the way that the rocker arm setup on these suspension arms is, you actually do get quite a bit of chassis roll. Let's see, that's Kyle after Phoenix. God, it's bringing back days of running oval up at Trackside. Woohoo! Say, it does donuts just fine. So it does the oval, okay? Let's see how it does just driving around, too. After Milwaukee. It's got really nice control power slides, and it actually does remind me quite a bit of the Kent Block Gymkhana car a bit. The main thing to remember with four-wheel drive is if you tend to get sideways, your throttle is your friend, because the front end will help pull you around as you're driving. I didn't like where that cone was anyways with that one. After Chicago. Running the oval, it actually seems a little bit peppier now too. This is our second pack on it. I think that's a good sign that the motor is really starting to break in. You'll probably take about two or three packs through it before the brushes and the motor really seat in and you get maximum performance. After Atlanta. Oh, finally got the box. I mean, overall the performance is pretty good. I mean, it's not difficult to drive. The main thing to remember is to stay on the power to pull you through corners. I could see maybe thickening up the front shock oil or going to a stiffer front spring to desensitize the front end a little bit, or even a front sway bar. After Darlington, this Titan 12 turn does actually deliver a decent amount of pep. I'd be really interested to see what the Valenian version of this truck does. So that'll do it for our running for today, but before we leave you, we wanted to give you an inside look underneath this beautiful Lexan body at the chassis itself. We're gonna slide it right off. And here, as you can see, It's the same basic platform, as I mentioned earlier, as like the Kent Block Gymkhana car, the Boss 302 Mustang. It uses the cantilever style front and rear suspension on here, so it's got the inboard shocks. You have your Titan 12 turn motor on the top. Really nice heat sink that's on here too to help dissipate heat. Other than that, it is a four-wheel drive system. So as you can see here, you've got a front and rear gear differential. Your servo is mounted here, and then you have a battery door on this side of the chassis and on this side of the chassis. Out of the box, the way it comes, they recommend that you mount the battery to the left-hand side of the chassis. You can run dual packs if you want to. You can also run lipos. Other than that, the chassis is really simple to work on. Your pushrod links, steering links, camber links, and everything, they're all fixed links. It does provide a pivot ball style rear and front upright for connecting to the A-arms themselves. It's just kind of weird to see this massive motor in this small of a chassis. It'd be really interesting to see what it would handle like if you threw, you know, say just a 540 size brushless motor system in here, what it would run like if you reduce the center of gravity by getting a lighter weight motor up top. Great looking Goodyear Wrangler tires. They're officially licensed. The front and rear body mounts are pretty robust. They've got some flex built into them, so they will give and not break. One of the minor criticisms I have on this chassis, the fact the foam bumper could be a little bit longer to help better support the front valence on the body. Other than that, this is a pretty robust little chassis, and you know, I have not heard of any issues from anyone regarding performance, durability, anything like that. So they've got a good platform here, and it works very well in this application. So that'll wrap it up for our review here of the Traxxas 1/16th scale Kyle Busch Racing Camping World Truck Series truck. It's a mouthful. And the neat thing too is it's great to see someone who's been involved in the hobby as long as Kyle has been to get something like this, his own vehicle. That's right, Kyle's been involved in the hobby for many years. In fact, he used to work in the Hobbytown USA in Las Vegas when he was growing up, both he and his brother Kurt. So it's very cool to see something like this happen for someone who has been an RC enthusiast for many years. Overall, very fun platform. I'd love to see this start off as a spec series of racing. You know, I'm an oval fan at my core. It's where I started. This would be just a lot of fun to get 8 or 10 of these out on a parking lot somewhere and just boys have at it. So if you do have any comments or questions about anything that you've seen here today or anything RC in general, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.